have fish downstairs. A lot of butterflies. This is not a show. This is not a production of any kind. This is a lot of love and warmth and so forth. And allow me to get started. It says right here, ladies and gentlemen and family, I am one of your masters of ceremonies, Bob Ward. And I'll give you 5 minutes to say the name. Made my evening. Now I can get going. Okay. When we have a welcome and a bit from Rexburg history taking place here tonight, starting as an annual event, the Miss Rexburg Pageant is not just a beauty pageant. It encompasses their talents, their intelligences, and includes their future ambitions. And by the way, this Miss Rexburg Pageant does not just happen. To make this evening what it is the entire efforts of the Pageant family. And that family are people comprised of dozens of parents, civic leaders, church people, doctors, accountants, farmers, dentists, builders, business people, in fact, all the professions here in Rexburg and in our community. They've all banded together to help display the beauty of our 11 young ladies, as you'll see them tonight. We are proud of our community in its first 100 years, and we are starting on our bicentennial by honoring our youth, our young ladies, who will carry on this wonderful tradition for many generations to come. Allow me quickly to outline what's going to happen on our program tonight. First, Jared Shaver, he's our other master of ceremonies, and he's beautifully dressed like I am. Jared is the master of ceremonies on the production, you see, and will announce the contestant production. Now, this is the thing that the girls have worked on for weeks and weeks, so you will see a beautiful production number. I will introduce our judges for tonight, who are right here on my right, your left, front here. I need the light so I can read. Bless your heart, let me come to that. Then our 11 contestants will display their beautiful evening gowns and will introduce themselves along with the thoughts that they have for you. Our present reigning Miss Rexburg, Miss Hope Bryn Hall, she's sitting right down here in front, will perform her jazz dance, and she is participating in the state pageant in Boise, Idaho in a few days, and I know she's going to win. She's a bright, smart, pretty girl. We will introduce some special guests in the audience, after which Jared and I will introduce the contestants for their display of talents to be judged. Then our fantastic show orchestra that you heard tonight will play a special selection. Then Jared will announce our 11 beauties as they parade before you in their shrimp suits. Then while they are changing, I will play a few old goodies on the organ here. It was furnished by the Rexburg Music Center. And then we will see the contestants in their final appearance with Miss Rexburg, who will be ready to transfer the crown to the winner after the judges' selection are ready for the runner-ups and the special awards. Now before we get started, we will have an opening prayer. We've asked Brother Bob Smith, if he will come forward, please.
Our kind and gracious Father in heaven, we're thankful this evening for the opportunity that we have to gather here for this pageant. We're thankful for all of the work and the effort, the time and the talents that have all been combined to make this pageant a success. We are very much aware, Heavenly Father, of all of the effort that has gone into this, especially on the part of the young ladies. And we ask that Thy Spirit will be with them, that they may feel good within themselves, that they may perform the best of their abilities, and that those who have helped to bring this pageant to this point, that they will feel good about it, and that this evening will be a blessing to them, to all those who have participated and those who have come to watch. We thank you for this great land we live in. We're thankful for this town. We're thankful for Rexburg. We're thankful for this centennial year. We pray that thy spirit be with us, that we may remember those who have gone on before us, that we may look to them as an example, that we may forge ahead in the future, and that we will continue to help Rexburg remain and become a greater place for them. We say these things now, Father, in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And now the excitement starts, so I will turn the microphone over to Jared Shaver for the first moment. Thank you.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you very much. Uncle Bob, can I get you to do me a favor? Could you remove your microphone, hands? Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed a pleasure to welcome you here to the historic Rexburg Tabernacle so that you can take place and partake of an historic event. Hopefully, you will see a show that is not only entertaining, but enlightening, as well as informative. As to who the number ones are on the Rexburg Avenue. We would like to thank all those who have taken part in our program tonight, and we'll mention them a little later on. But right now, we'd like to introduce to you the contestants, the 1983 Miss Rexburg contestants. And the way they'll do that is in a jazz sort of rocky number that has been choreographed by Shelley Lundquist and Kathy Westmore. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1983 Miss Rexburg contestants, and hats off to Rexburg.
Thank you.
profession is being a judge. Now, these judges have been working with these girls, I guess, all day today, interviews, talking, getting their background, their feedback, and so on. I'd like very much to introduce these judges. 1, 2, 3. All right. I guess it comes out right. Mr. Floyd Miller, would you stand? Now, I think we've covered it. We're in heaven already. I should like very much at this time to introduce a very, very charming, very beautiful girl, and I think most of you have seen her before. I've had the privilege of working with her in the productions in the past few years. She's a former Miss Rexburg winner, and now she is the reigning Miss Idaho National Guard. And she is also going to, she's just telling you, she's also going to be participating in the Boise affair in the next few days. And tonight, her name is, well, every night, her name is Elaine Pack. And what a beauty she is. She's my darling granddaughter by adoption. And she's going to play the harp, naturally, called the Spanish Fantasy by Carlos Sancedo.
Thank you.
number one is the daughter of Ray and Janet Olson. Here she comes.
Thank you.
Excuse me, this is contestant number 6.
Thank you.
property of Evelyn, daughter of Lynn and Andrew Spell.
Ladies and gentlemen, aren't they a lovely sight? Thank you, ladies. Actually, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you a very special young lady. I happened to meet her just a few days ago, and it was very enjoyable for me. She's a very bright young lady, very talented, and we kind of forced her into performing for us tonight. She will be traveling to Boise on June 11th, representing Rexburg, Idaho. Now, that's kind of a special place to me, and I will be to you. Most of you, some of you from Rigby and Chicago City, but you can pretend a lot of people. I'd like to introduce Ms. Hope Rimmel to do a jazz dance for you. Ladies and gentlemen, Hope Rimmel. special little presentation for you, just to get you a little better acquainted with each one of the girls. We've got a small slide presentation for you, which will take just a moment to set up. I'd like to especially thank some real good folks, Nina and Sherry Homer, who own Rental Video here in town. They're videotaping this evening so that each one of our girls, and any of you who would like, can have a tape. And I think that's kind of nice. Thank you very much. Understandably, some of you understand that to be a commercial, and it was. Unfortunately, it's a 10-second one, it's a little better than television, I'd say. Ladies and gentlemen, the contestants for 1983, Ms. Rexburg, and the slide presentation.
Thank you.
in hand by Ms. Lori Beckley, our co-chairman of this committee. This evening, and as well as all of the tabulation of what the judges calculate, is being done very graciously by Randy Schmidt. And Randy, would you stand, please, for us? Thank you. Now I'd like to introduce our co-chair persons for our event, for the Miss Rexburg Pageant. Miss Lori Beckman.
Get all of their good ones just looking at their mothers. Isn't that true, Mom?
My mother has beautiful looks too, can't you tell? Wait a minute. Let me carry away with that. We'd like to begin now by going into the talent competition. Now, in each one of these, the girls are required to keep their talent under 2 minutes and 50 seconds. Now, that's kind of tough sometimes, but they've all managed to do it. Some of them have done original dances. Some of them play by ear with no music. All of them have memorized pieces. They put a lot of time into these talents. We'd like to begin this evening with Uncle Bob.
There are. Please. If this is too right, I'll turn it down. The first one is a vocal solo by Mary Ann Olson.
Thank you.
jazz dance. Miss Stacy Larson. Saxophone solo. Ladies and gentlemen, play that song. as commemorate what we recall. We'll be doing a jazz night, of course.
It's true.
And I would like to have contestant number 10. We'll be doing what we call a sewing spree. She calls sewing by narration. You can call it after you've seen it. Miss Corinne Jensen and the sewing spree.
Thank you.
plastic shells. Now, we'd like to take the time to give the band just a little bit of time to show off. Ladies and gentlemen, the Rexburg, the other band. I guess that's what I was saying. The other band.
God, we're burning, and I feel like
you a little earlier today. As a matter of fact, right about 12 o'clock, each of the contestants had a chance to stand before the judges. This is just a review for you. They've already seen the swing suit competition, but we'd like to present it just for your sake. Ladies and gentlemen, the swing suit competition. Ladies and gentlemen, the swimsuit competition for 19 years. friend of mine whom I met, about how long ago? About 3 years now. Bob's a funny kind of a guy. Even though he looks silver and gray, old, decrepit, falling around. Even though he looks a little mature, inside he's one of the biggest kids' hearts you'll ever hear about or you'll ever witness. Ladies and gentlemen, this is one of Rexburg's most complete gentlemen. Now I have witnessed this man do wondrous things on an organ. Bob, can we entice you to sit down at that organ?
There is one here. That's right. There is one here. All right. I'll give it a go.
Would you please?
What I have in mind is, first of all, Jerry brought this electronic machine over here, and I'm having fun with it. I would like to play a medley that would suit these girls from my era. But I would like to do about five numbers, and I'm sure that these girls beautifully. I'll start out with a beautiful number called Dream, because this is what these girls are doing. And these are Girl of My Dreams. This is the beautiful waltz. And then another one, Let Me Call You Sweetheart, because I think we all feel this way about the 11 beautiful sweethearts of ours here. And then another one, a little jump tune called Satin Doll. Now for you younger people, this is, goes over your head, of course. And then they all end up with possibly, if we need more time, I'd want a few more, but we're trying to let the girls change here. But a real good one that we've been doing tonight is called Hey, Look Me Over. Okay?
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rock.
Thank you.
pro tem, Ms. Corinne Jensen. Contestant number 11, Ms. Michelle Smith. Ladies and gentlemen, on the lovely side. Ladies and gentlemen, what we'd like to do is make the presentations of the non-finalists first, and then Miss Congeniality, and our two fine runners-up, and Miss Rexburg, in that order. We do have some lovely gifts and exciting certificates and things that a lot of people have given us. The cedar chest that you saw as you came in was donated by Hanson's Furniture, and it is a lovely piece. I hope that you'll pay attention to what's happening in the program there as we announce all of these, so that you can follow just as fast and as easily as I can. Hopefully we're fairly close to that. Maybe we aren't close to that. We actually have four non-finalist awards. The first award is a $1,000 scholarship. Excuse me, the Career Scholarship to Career Beauty College is a finalist award. You can receive that as well as belong to one of the finalist awards. There are three non-finalists. That is $200 best musical, a $200, I don't know how to say this, best non-musical and non-best musical, best non-musical. And then there's a $100 participation ticket award. Okay? If they're almost ready, can you give me a sign? I can song and dance if I'd like. Song and dance. Oh boy, this is going to be a throw. Okay, I'll tell you what. All song and dance only on one condition. I have to do this again next year. Let's see, what can we do? T for two. You're going to do T for two? I'm going to do T. I'm not going to do T for two. You play T for two and I'll figure out something. Okay, here we go. We'll get it together. Ladies and gentlemen, keep us kind of abreast of what's happening. The band will do a song, and then I'll do a song and dance, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, the other band.
Cast anchor on the outer.
next. Now, aren't you glad for that? We'd like to start out with the award for selling the most tickets. Kareem Jensen. Now this is the $1,000 Beauty College Scholarship. And that award goes to Miss Lisa Smith.
She will get a $300 scholarship from Golden, Rexburg Food Center, Jensen Optical, and the sponsorship. Stacy, as Miss Rexburg, we're proud of you. She has a few months to go to run for that.
$500 cash scholarship for that.
I'm glad to be, we've just come, we like your, good night.